स्टार्ट नाउ. गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन फ्रॉम लाहौर पाकिस्तान. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई जस्ट विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट ऑफ हेल्थ एंड प्रॉस्पेरिटी टू ऑल ऑफ यू डूइंग दीज चैलेंजिंग टाइम्स ऑफ कोविड 19 पेंडेमिक. माय नेम इज डॉक्टर अलीना शेराजी एंड रिगार्डिंग माय अचीवमेंट्स आई डिड एमबीबीएस इन 2014. आई एम अ मेंबर ऑफ कॉलेज ऑफ फिजिशियन एंड सर्जन पाकिस्तान. आई एम एमआरसीओजी फ्रॉम यूके एंड आल्सो आई एम आरसीपीआई फ्रॉम आयरलैंड. I am a fellow of European Board of Obstetrics and Gynecology, Belgium, and a European Fellow of Medical Education. I am fully registered with GMC and presently serving as a senior registrar in a government hospital, Lahore, Pakistan. And I'm happily married and blessed with 3 kids. You will be tested in all 5 domains. In some of the tasks, there may be just 2 or 3 domains may be present, but the communication with patients and colleagues or the patient's safety will be present on every task. Okay, number one is the patient safety. It is one of the most important domains which usually applied in the clinical practice. Checking the patient name, age, and date of birth comes in the patient safety because different patients have different names. You need to compare the notes of the patient from the name of the patient. You also need to confirm the age and as well as the date of birth of the patient or the role play. Warning advice. The red flag sign is also come in the patient safety. For example, if you have a patient and she's going to opt for the medical management for the termination of the pregnancy, she will go home. You need to say that if you have any pain in your tummy, if you have any discharge from your down, if you have fever, if you are feeling unwell, you need to report immediately to us. You need to recognize your limitations. When you need to call for the help. For example, if in the labor board situation, you have a patient comes with a PPH, then it is important to call for the help to your senior, to anesthetist, need to inform the consultant. If you are going to doing surgery and you have a certain type, you have to deal with a certain type of the complication, you need to involve your senior. Maintain confidentiality is also very much important. It comes under the Data Protection Act. And you need to maintain the confidentiality at each and every cost. But there are certain situations in which you can break the confidentiality, in which comes under the Caldecott principle. And definitely we will discuss today, discuss in our next session, which is a session on ethical and legal issues. You need to respect the patient dignity by saying that, is it okay if I examine you just to read about either the pregnancy is going appropriate according to your pregnancy, and I will just examine you in the presence of chaperone. And it is important to say that because in UK, you cannot examine the patient without the presence of the chaperone. Respect patient beliefs is also very important. This comes under the patient autonomy. If the patient is Jehovah's Witness and she is not going to accept the blood transfusion, then you need to accept that as well. The WHO checklist is also comes under the patient safety, and exclude pregnancy before surgery is also very important. It is a point of the patient safety. Second is that you need to see the recent report of the pap smear. Is it normal or not normal, and how many years back the recent report is. Okay, domain two is communication with patients and colleagues. Just point out, you need to speak slowly and clearly. Okay, when you need to communicate with the patient and you are going to enter the cubicle, just enter with a big smile. You need to become confident. You need to become focused at the time when you enter the cubicle. And if you are a foreigner like me, maybe you speak certainly more frequently. So just try and practice, speak slowly and clearly. Rapport building is very important, in which you can say that, good afternoon, my name is Dr. Alina, and I'm one of the senior doctors in the antenatal clinic today. Can I confirm your full name, please? How would you like me to call you? Please call me Alina. It is important so that it will build a doctor-patient relationship. Then you can break ice by saying, do you have any concerns and expectations that you want to discuss with me before we begin today's consultation? Body language is very important, in which you need to have an eye-to-eye contact with the patient. In an active listening gesture, you can say, make some noises, It will give an impression that you are hearing the patient, and it will further prompt the patient to speak and to tell and explore if there is any hidden agenda. You can lead forward, and hand-holding all comes under the body language. Showing empathy is very important. You need to show with your facial expressions that you can feel the pain of the patient. especially in the cases of breaking bad news, and recognize how she feels. If the patient say that she lost her mother few days ago and she is feeling depressed, you need to say that, oh, I'm so sorry to hear about. Do you have any concerns? Do you need some support? So you need to say this. Try to avoid the medical jargon. You don't need to say that I'm going to give you analgesia, I'm going to give you the antibiotics. You can say that I'm going to give you the painkiller, I'm going to give you the medication against the infection. Always try to give the information in the form of chunks. Means you need to give a small information, and after that you may need to ask. Okay, so there are certain people who want to admit in the meeting. Just give me a second. Admit all. Participant. Okay, Rashida. Okay, so need to give the information in the form of chunks. Every time you need to say, am I clear so far? Do you have any concern? Anything you want to discuss with me? Any questions you may have? Just need to give information in a small chunk. Okay, try to be honest every time. The role player or the patient didn't expect you that you know everything. If you don't know anything, then just say, and I will let it confirm from my senior, and then I will tell you. For example, if the patient say that if the patient is having a baby and she's having the baby is having the anencephaly, and the patient ask about, is there any treatment regarding the head transplantation? You can just say that at that time I don't know, but I will talk to my senior and let you know if there is any treatment like that is present or not. Just try to be honest every time. Even if you forget anything, don't worry. Just say that I don't know at this time, but I will let you know. Stop frequently. Check if the information has been understood. Offer, repeat if not understood. Okay, so am I clear so far? I'm going to give you a lot of information today. So some of the information is quite complicated. If there is anything that I have not explained you really clearly, please tell me. I will try to do better. Encourage her to ask questions. Do you have any questions? Decision should be shared and agreed with the patient. You can negotiate the decision. You can say that I'm the one who will help you to take the right decision, but you are the one who have to take the decision for yourself. I can only help you, but you have to take the decision. This is the patient autonomy. Use appropriate connectors and signposting. I really understand your concerns. I really understand your worries. Being a mother, your concerns are absolutely genuine. You can use these certain connectors, and it will give these connectors are basically very important, and it shows that you are hearing the patient, and it shows that you are giving the importance to the patient. So it is important to use these connectors. Domain 3 is communication with the colleague. In the communication with the colleague, you can then ask for the senior to help when you involve the multidisciplinary team. For example, in case of the urogynecology, in case of oncology, in case of when there is certain fetal anomaly, the SPR and sharing patient handover, in which there is a situation, background, assessment and recommendation tool, in which you will give the patient to your colleague. Teaching stations and structured viva are all communication with colleagues. One thing you need to be noted, don't ever blame the colleague. Never. If the patient comes and say that the GP has given me the wrong medication, I'm so much overweight, and the GP has prescribed me this oral contraceptive pills, I have read in the Google and I have searched in the Google, it is not a safe option for me. You can say that. At this time, I really don't know that why the GP prescribed you. But I will talk to the GP, I will inform the GP. If there is anything like that, I will tell the GP so that this will not happen with anyone else in the future. Domain 4 is applied knowledge. You need to give answers as per guideline. You need to give a focused answer. Clinical interpretation of results are very important. If you have a patient with a hyperemesis gravidarum, there are certain results are were present, and you need to interpret either there is any hypokalemia or hyperkalemia, what are the results, what are the level of LFTs are, what did the thyroid functional test show. And the management should start from examination, investigation. All the investigation should be relevant, and you need the treatment will be either conservative, medical, and surgical. You need to remember that doing nothing is also an option. Discuss the risk and benefits of all options and let the patient decide. As I have already told you that you need to say that I'm the one who I'm going to give you a lot. Today I'm just going to give you all the necessary information relevant to your condition, and I will help you to take the right decision for yourself, but you are the one who have to take decision. Important thing is that always justify your investigation and the management plan. If you say that I'm going to arrange an ultrasound for you, just say I'm going to arrange an ultrasound to see either the baby is growing appropriately for your pregnancy, what the fluid around the baby is, and you need to say that I just want to see either the blood flow of the baby is fine or not, what is the position of the baby. If you will just say that I'm going to arrange an ultrasound, you will never have a mark for that. You need to say always justify, try to justify that why you are going for these investigations. Information gathering. Take relevant and target history. Try to pick up the clues. You should make a template in your mind and then modify accordingly. Preferable to ask open questions. Ask from the patient that how the pain is like, what type of the discharge you have. Can you please tell me something more about your pain? Can you please something more about your discharge? So that the patient can tell you each and everything. If the patient is having problem with the period, you can say that, can you please tell me something more about your period? So if the patient missed anything, then you can ask the closed-ended question. Be logical, be organized, and the end you need to ask. Is there anything you'd like to add more? Summarize the history to reinforce. Important to complete the history in 3 to 4 minutes. Okay, what to expect outside the cubicle? These are the very important 2 minutes. First thing is that you need to read the task carefully. You need to say, what is the task? Is it a simulated patient task, or is it a simulated colleague task, or you are going to see a relative? And what the task is expecting? Assessing. Either the task is assessing the patient's safety, either the task is assessing your communication, and either the task is assessing the applied knowledge. Patient safety and applied knowledge is almost always present. Patient safety and applied knowledge is almost present at every time. But if there is an information gathering, this means that the history is required. You need to write down the important things in a big letter. Just a minute. There is again some interruption. Okay, you will have a pen and a paper in your hand, which will be provided before you enter in the examination room. So you need to write the important things in the big letter, like the name of the patient, the age, and the main complaint in the GP letter. You need to write task number 1, 2, and 3. In the one, you can write history taking, 2, investigation, examination, 3, the management plan. If there are too many people, just read what you can, go inside, and after introducing yourself, take permission from the role player or examination to finish them. Sarah, is it okay if I took 1 minute to finish reading the notes provided so that I can make sure that I didn't miss anything? So this will build up a rapport with your role player and as well as in the front of examiner. Inside the cubicle, when you enter inside the cubicle, these are the 10 minutes, which are very important 10 minutes. I just advise you all to try to practice to finish the task in 10 minutes. First, you need to greet and introduce yourself by name. Good afternoon. My name is Dr. Alina, and I'm one of the senior doctors in the clinic today, with a big smile, and introduce your role and confirm. Can I confirm your full name, please, and your date of birth? What would you like me to call you, Sarah? Please call me Alina. Confirm the purpose of meeting. Sarah, I understand that I have a letter from your GP, and the GP said that you have a condition, diabetes in the pregnancy. Is it correct? Then put the agenda. So Sarah, what I like to do today is I just need to ask few questions first. So then I will examine you. If needed, may run some of the investigations for you. And then we will make a shared management plan depend upon your wishes and expectations. Then you can say, should I carry on? When you finish the history in 3 minutes, at the end of your history, you can ask from the patient, is there anything I have not asked and you want me to know? Then you can summarize the important points. Even you can ask the role player to summarize the important points. Don't forget the body language and eye-to-eye contact, which is very important. Be in the listening gesture, nod, head nodding. So it will give an idea to the role player and as well as to the examiner that you are an active listener. And don't look at the notes too frequently, and don't repeat the information or don't repeat your question too frequently, because it gives an impression that you are not hearing the role player and you are not confident. Okay, so you can offer the examination if needed, offer the only relevant test, but you need to say why you need these tests to run off, and you need to offer examination. You just need to say why you want the examination. You can negotiate a shared management plan and explain the possible risk and the benefits. And you can also discuss the alternatives as well. What to expect inside the cubicle in the structure viva? You need to greet, introduce yourself by name. Good afternoon. My name is Dr. Alina. I'm one of the exam candidates here today. And I've been asked, this is a session of the preoperative ward round, and I have go through all the notes of all the 5 patients, and I am ready for the structure viva. This is the agenda. Follow the provided instructions. If the examiner asks what information you need to know, just answer the most relevant information that you want to know. Don't say, repeat the points of all history templates. You need to be focused. If the communication and information gathering is done towards the right path, you will impress the examiner and gain confidence. You can explain the pros and cons by, I will outweigh the risk of stopping the anticoagulants versus the benefit. I will outweigh the risk of stopping venous thromboembolism by stopping the anticoagulants versus the benefits of bleeding at the time of operation. If you will say like this, then it will impress the examiner. You can explain the management plan by first line, second line, and third line management. For example, if you have a role player or the patient with PMS, you can say that the first line option is SSRI, SNRI, and a continuous combined oral contraceptive pills. The second is a continuous progesterone with micronized progesterone, and the third line is the hysterectomy. So you need to explain the management plan by first line, second line, and third line. I hope I'm clear to all. So moving forward towards our next slide. Remember, be confident. You did what you can up to your limits. Now let it go. Odds patients are odds for all. Don't be panicked. If you follow the simple rule for each module, you will pass. Try to be always polite. Do not blame the colleague. Even if you feel you know nothing about the station, put in mind that role play will hopefully give you some hints to guide. If you start the station right, this will give you confidence and impress all role player, examiner, and as well as the lay examiner. For example, if you have a station and you don't have any idea about the station, and you have a good communication skill, relevant information gathering, and if you adopt a listening gesture and you show yourself that you are a safe doctor, then you can pass the task. Okay, moving forward towards the history taking template. Okay, the starting is almost the same for the obstetrics history and as well as the gynecology history. You need to read, introduce yourself and confirm the identity and age. As I have already been explained to you, that you can say, good afternoon, my name is Dr. Alina and I'm one of the senior doctors in the antenatal clinic today. Can you confirm your full name, please, and your date of birth? What would you like me to call you? Please call me Alina. You can break ice by check the purpose of the meeting. I understand that this is your first pregnancy and you are 34 weeks pregnant. Is that correct? So congratulations. Do you have any expectations or any concerns that you want to discuss with me before we begin today's consultation? Then you need to set an agenda. What I like to do today, Sarah, I just need to ask you questions first so that I will be in the better position to discuss. Then I will examine you if needed and may run some of the investigations for you. And then we will make a shared management plan and I will make the options available for you depending upon your wishes and expectations. Then you need to come towards the history of presenting illness. Always show empathy. If the patient says, I have a pain in the tummy, you need to say, oh, I'm so sorry to hear about it. It must be very difficult for you. How did it affect you, either socially, psychologically, and economically? Then reassure her, Sarah, I will try my best to help you as much as I can. But first, I just need to ask you questions first so that I will be in the better position to discuss. This is an obstetric history template. You need to ask, Sarah, is it your planned pregnancy or an unplanned pregnancy? If it is unplanned pregnancy, then how you conceive, either spontaneously or after IVF? Well, Sarah, congratulations. If unplanned pregnancy, then ask, are you happy with the pregnancy or welcome the pregnancy or think about the termination of the pregnancy? Okay, so how far are you in your pregnancy, Sarah? And how's the pregnancy so far? The patient will say that I'm 34 weeks pregnant and everything is just fine right now. And all scans and blood tests okay? Are all scans and blood tests okay? And how are you feeling like right now? This is a journal template of obstetrical history which you need to ask from all obstetric patients. In past history, you need to ask, have you ever been pregnant before? Can you tell me more about those pregnancies? How you delivered? Either you delivered by spontaneously vaginal delivery or by cesarean section. Any problems you have in that pregnancy at the time of delivery and after the delivery? Do you have baby boy or a girl and how they are going now? If the termination, were they were for personal reasons? For the future, what is your plan for the future pregnancy? Uh-huh. Have you completed your family?
I'm not sure, Alendi. I'm not coming.
No, there is extra there.
Just a minute. There is some interruption is going here. Give me. Okay, I'm going to fix the problem. Just a second. Okay, it's fine. Okay, so in the future, what is your plan for the future pregnancy? Have you completed your family? Okay, so the gynecological history. What, when was your last period? Or you can ask, what's the date of your last period? Can you tell me more about your period? This is an open-ended question. The patient can say that, yes, I have a regular period. I didn't have any problem with my periods. Or the patient can say, I am having an irregular period. I'm having so much pain and I'm having a heavy bleeding in the days of my period. So that gives an opportunity to the role play to speak. So if the role play will speak, it will give that impression that you are an active listener and also to the examiner that you are giving an opportunity to the role play to speak. You can ask about the period for how many days you have the bleeding and after how many days do you have any pain in the days of your period? Oh, I'm so sorry, Sarah. It must be very difficult for you. Are you on any form of contraception right now? Are your smear up to date and normal? You should need to ask this question if the patient is more than 25 years old, not less than 25 years. If relevant, if the patient has any problem with the bleeding, you need to ask, do you have any problem of bleeding in between your periods? Moving forward towards the gynecological history, the sexual history is also a part of the gynecological history. You know, don't need to so much explore the sexual history in every task. But you should need to ask the sexual history in detail if there is a task like if the patient is less than 24 years, if there is a young girl present for the contraception and for the termination, then you need to ask these questions. Sarah, first, I just want to reassure you that what we discuss today is strictly confidential. I will not discuss with anyone without your consent. you may find it a little bit intrusive, but please, could you tell me at what age you had your first sex? Up till now, how many sexual partners did you have? Are you with someone right now, Sarah? Were you with someone before your current partner in the last 6 months? Do you use any protection like condoms? Do you have any discharge from the down below? Or your partner have problem of discharge? How is the general health of your partner? So this is the template of sexual history. This is a general template you can follow and can apply it to either the obstetrical history or the gynecological history. In the medical history, you can just ask, Sarah, how's your general health be like? If she has any medical problem, then you need to ask, when was you diagnosed? Either the problem is controlled or not. Are you regularly following your physician or GP? And when did you last visit your GP? And are you following the advice? From the family history, you need to ask, is there any illness that runs in your family that you want me to know? If you have a patient with a cancer, and if you have a patient like heavy bleeding and have a patient with abdominal mass, you can just ask, say, Sarah, I just need to ask a few questions. You should not need to be worried about. This is a question I usually ask from all of my patients or all of the ladies. Do you have any cancer runs in your family? You need to ask like this. Otherwise, the patient will say, oh my God, doctor, am I having a cancer? So first of all, you just need to reassure the role player that this is the question you are going to ask from all of your patients. Regarding the past surgical history, you can ask, do you have any surgery that went on your tummy before? Or can ask on your tummy or pelvis or down below. From the social history, you need to ask, what do you do for your living? Are you with someone now? If she is unemployed, you need to ask, who supports you and your children? Is everything okay at home? I'm sorry if you find some of my questions intruding, or you may find it a little bit intrusive, but I just need to ask from all of my patients, do you smoke? If she says yes, then you need to ask, are you a regular smoker? How many cigarettes do you smoke? And just need to ask from the patient, I'm not going to judge you, Sarah, but do you have any idea that smoking can be harmful for your health and as well as for your baby? Have you ever thought to quit smoking? If you thought to quit smoking, you can refer her to the NHS Stop Smoking Program. You can also ask, do you drink alcohol? If yes, how many drinks? And ever she got drunk? Do you use any drugs? If yes, can you please tell me what type of drugs? Do you share needles? So this all is the patient's safety. This is a general template you all can apply to either the obstetrical history or the gynecological history. Psychological history. This is a very important, especially in preconceptual counseling and antenatal stations. Ask two screening questions. During the past month, have you been bothered by feeling down and depressed? During the past month, have you often been bothered by having little interest or in doing things? So you need to ask these two screening questions, especially in the preconceptional period or in the antenatal stage. If any of the questions become in the form of yes, then you need to ask, is there something you think about? Do you need some help with it? Drugs and allergy. Are you on any drugs right now? If she take the folic acid, you need to ask the dose of the folic acid. Either it's in the 400 microgram or 5 milligram. Are you allergic to anything? Don't say, are you allergic to any drugs? Need to say, are you allergic to anything? You can also say, are you allergic to any herbal, any non-herbal medication? If yes, ask, what happened when you take that drug? Either you need to admit in the hospital or not. And thank you for... just say, thank you so much for telling me, Sarah. I'm going to mention it in your notes and even inform your GP and will not give you this antibiotic before your operation. Thank you so much for letting me know. Is there anything I have not, at the end, you can just say these lines. Is there anything I have not asked and you want me to know? Thank you so much for sharing the information. Okay. All those joining now, please keep your mics off. Ending. At the end, you can say you can apply this to your obstetrical history and as well as to your gynecological history. I won't expect you to take the decision straight away, Sarah. I think I have given you a lot of information. You can take your time, discuss it with your partner. I'm going to fix another appointment in the few days ahead. You will let me know when you have finalized about your treatment. If you have any questions, I will be happy to answer. I'm going to provide you some of the information leaflets, and I'm going to inform your GP as well. You can also say that, Sarah, I think today I have given you a lot of information. Some of the information is quite complicated. If there is anything I have not explained really clearly, please tell me. I will try to do better. Okay, so this is the task. And who want to participate? Dr. Rukaiya? Yes, she's Rukaiya. Rukaiya? Dr. Rukaiya, I'm unmuting you.
Yes, doctor.
Okay, so this is your task. You have 2 minutes to read the task. Then you have 10 minutes to perform.
Okay.
So your time start now.
Okay, doctor.
Okay, Rukaiya, are you ready?
2 minutes is done, doctor. Okay.
You can take your time. You can take your time.
Yes, doctor, we can start.
Okay, start.
Okay. Hello, I'm Dr. Rukaiya, one of the doctors here. May I confirm your name and age, please?
I'm Sarah, and I'm 30 years old.
Okay, hi, Sarah. So, how are you feeling now, Sarah, after the operation?
Doctor, why didn't you tell me that you did such a big operation on me? Why, doctor?
Yes, Sarah, I can understand, Sarah, and I can see you are upset about it.
Sarah, I am, but I just want to see the consultant. I don't want to talk to you right now. I just want to see the consultant.
Yes, Sarah, I will make the arrangement for the consultant and he will review you shortly and will see you and will answer all your questions. So,
okay, then please tell me that why this happened with me. It was told to them, a small procedure and the pregnancy tissue inside and you are going to remove that pregnancy tissue. Then after the end of the operation, I have just seen on my tummy, there are a lot of stitches there on my tummy, but then why, doctor, why this happened with me?
Yes, Sarah, I can see and I can understand that you are angry about all these things. But Sarah, I'll tell you all the details about what happened and how we managed you. So do you have any idea about what happened? Has anybody told you about it?
Nobody told you. I have just wake up and I just see that there are stitches there. Please tell me why this happened with me. I'm going to complain.
Yes, Sarah. Yeah, sure, Sarah. If at all you want to complain, we can take things forward from here. And so let me tell you about what happened. If you don't know anything about it, as you had come for with the products of pregnancy in the womb, am I right?
Yes, you are.
Yes, and then you were planned for emptying of the womb by the tube through the suction.
Yes.
Is that all right?
Yes. Hello everyone. Is my voice clear to all of you? A very good evening to all.
Okay, carry on.
Hello.
Okay, carry on.
Yeah. So, Sarah. So while the procedure was being performed, there was an accidental puncture in the womb.
Okay, then.
I'm sorry.
Then why didn't you inform me?
Yes, Sarah, as it was, and a puncture of the womb happened, and you were under you were under sleep, and we diagnosed that it was detected timely. So the decision for the repair was taken.
Okay. So.
Yeah. And
I'm not satisfied, doctor. I think I have to complain right now.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Sarah. We have already initiated a report on this, and if you want to take things further, there you have all the right to complain. And there is.
Have you removed my womb? Have you removed my womb?
No, Sarah. No, Sarah. That is, we have not removed the womb. To tell you further details, as we were talking about it, because there was a puncture, so then and it was timely detected. So a keyhole surgery was done, and a telescope was put, and that puncture was repaired timely, and in a competent and the right manner.
Okay. So am I going to get pregnant again?
Mm-hmm. Yes, Sarah, as of because it was a keyhole surgery, we don't see an issue of you not conceiving and becoming pregnant in the future. Whenever you are physically and emotionally fit, you can embark on pregnancy. And for your other aspect of lodging a complaint, we have there is a provision of what we call as patient association liaison service, that is called PALS. And you can lodge a complaint further, and the investigations will be done in a soft, in an honest and transparent manner, and the details will be given to you timely.
Okay, so if I become pregnant, what should I do?
Yes, Sarah, whenever you become pregnant in the future, please inform the GP so that early booking of your case can be done, and we look after you from the very beginning.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Sarah, that this has happened. And we are here to support you. And we have started you on the surgery was a short and successful surgery. And so you'll be further given painkillers, if required, antibiotics. And a complete discharge card will be prepared for you. And we will call you for follow-up. And if you have any pain or any bleeding or any complaint, you can always come back to us and contact at the hospital number. Any other concerns you have, Sarah?
No, I don't have any. Thank you.
Yeah, and I will also fix up an appointment with my consultant. And as you said earlier, you want to see my consultant. So you can meet the consultant and discuss anything further which you would like to.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so Rukaya, well done, and you are almost on the right path, but you need to show more empathy towards the patient. As she lost her baby, she has a miscarriage, you need to feel sorry for that. I'm so sorry that you lost your baby. And the rest of the thing is, let's just try to explain a little bit more that, Sarah, what I did was for your best interest. Okay, so there is a template I've made for you all. Sarah, please, Rukaya, mute your mic, and so there will be no interruption here. So this is a template for an angry patient. If there is any angry patient, you can apply this template to all. Sometimes the patient comes with retained swab. Sometimes there is an episiotomy done and patient complain of having a retained swab. Sometimes the patient is having, there is a case of placenta previa and accidentally, or there is some perforation to the, and accidentally there is some damage to bowel and bladder can take place, or sometimes it may end up into the hysterectomy. So the patient may come, the patient can become very angry. So this is a template you all can apply to all the angry patients. So first identify the patient is angry, usually written behind the cubicle in the task. Okay. So when you introduce and confirm your identity, be calm, confident, and cool. Keep at a safe distance. Don't smile. Don't say nice to meet you. Just say that, good afternoon. My name is Dr. Alina and I'm one of the senior doctors in the hospital today. Can I confirm your full name, please, and your date of birth? Just don't say that, how would you like me to call you and please call me Alina. Don't say that. Then you need to explain the aim of the meeting. Sarah, I'm here today just to talk with you what happened yesterday and to explain any question that you may have. Okay, so then the third step is avoid conflict in the honest way. Give time to react. If the patient will not react, the patient will never be cooled down. Just give her time to react. Don't say that you tried your best. Just say that, Sarah, what I did was for your best interest. You were bleeding heavily at that time. It was not possible to take your consent. You were under the anesthesia. You were under the sleep. So what we do is I just called a consultant to assess the damage. So, Sarah, I'm really sorry that this happened with you. You can just say that, Sarah, this is a recognized complication of the procedure and usually happen less than 1 out of 1,000 ladies or the women. I'm so sorry, Sarah, this happened with you. I'm so sorry. Please accept my apologies. This is the duty of condo. Don't be defensive. Never, never, ever try to justify yourself. Just point or provide the solution. You can say that, Sarah, the complication has been happened. Can you give me the chance so that I can explain you how to deal with these complications? Diffuse anger. Accept what went wrong. I'm sorry, Sarah. I understand that this happened with you. I'm so sorry. This is a duty of condo. And be honest every time. If the patient want to have a complaint procedure, offer them that, yes, we have a complaint procedure and there is a PAL center. I'm going to tell you that as well. At the end, there will be a mutual agreement. When the anger becomes dissolved, the patient can come for the mutual agreement. Okay, so I'm going to apply that template in the provided task. Let's see. Introduction and confirm identity. Good afternoon. I'm Dr. Alina, one of the senior doctors in the hospital. Don't say nice to meet you. May I confirm your name, please, and your date of birth? I think you remember me, Sarah. We met yesterday. I was a doctor who did your operation. Today, I'm here to discuss with you what happened yesterday and to answer any question that you may have. Third point, avoid conflict in an honest way. Sarah, I'm so sorry for your baby. No doubt, you are passing through a very hard time. Patient will ask, why did you not tell me? You can say that, you had every right to know, Sarah. I arrived immediately after the operation to see you, but you were sedated at that time. Don't be defensive. Sarah, what I did was for your best interest. You presented with heavy bleeding with incomplete miscarriage. Some of the pregnancy tissue was still inside the womb at that time. It was necessary to remove the pregnancy tissue. So I took your consent and made preparation for your operation. We confirmed you in the proper way according to the protocol of our hospital. Because sometimes the patient may say that you did my surgery, maybe you have, maybe there is some other person or maybe some other patient have that type of the surgery. You did wrong with me or something like that. You can say that we can confirm you in the proper way according to the protocol of our hospital. Took you down to the OT or operation theater and placed you under the sleep to remove the pregnancy tissue. When the patient say, I want to see the consultant. Yes, Sarah, you have every right to see the consultant. In fact, the consultant will talk to you in the morning. But this dissolves anger and duty of condo. I feel it's my responsibility to explain you what happened. As I was a surgeon who operated you, would you please allow me to continue? Sarah, this is a recognized complication of the procedure and happens in less than 1 out of 1,000 women. Unfortunately, this happened with you. I'm sorry, Sarah, but good thing is that we have dealt with the situation and everything is fine right now. I hope you understand. Sarah, during the pregnancy, womb becomes soft to carry a baby. At that time, it became more vulnerable to damage. At that time, when I was removing the pregnancy tissue, the instrument went through the wall of the womb and you started bleeding heavily. Because you were sedated, it was not possible to take the consent. As your life was my foremost priority, I didn't want to lose you, Sarah. So I immediately called my senior to assess the damage and we passed a camera inside your tummy to the belly button to see the extent of damage and took few stitches on your womb. That's how we deal with the complication timely and save your precious life. Sarah, will you accept my apology? This is the duty of condo. Then the last is the mutual agreement. Just a second. Okay, I'm admitting the participants. Okay, so the mutual agreement. The patient will say, will I be able to pregnant again? Definitely, Sarah. However, I recommend you to take effective contraception for the few months until you are physically and psychologically ready to accept the pregnancy. In addition, I advise you to avoid coil and combine pills at that time. Sarah, if I become pregnant, what should I do? For the next pregnancy, you need to book early in consultant care unit. We will do an earlier scan to confirm the location of pregnancy because there is a risk of having the pregnancy out. And we'll discuss the possibility of the cesarean section. There is some interruption here. Just a second, I'm going to mute the new participants. Please mute your mic, everyone, please. Okay. So this is a complaint procedure. I have tried to write in an easy way. We call such events, just a second. Okay. So we call such events as adverse clinical events, and our hospitals take such events so seriously and investigate fully to find out why this happened, to prevent this in the future. If you say that, I can arrange your meeting with the consultant to discuss the results of the investigation. If the patient still not agree after the first step, you can say that, okay, I'm going to offer you to the PAL service, which is a patient advice and life patient service of our hospital, whose job is to deal with the complaints, as all complaints are the responsibility of chief executive of the hospital. When the investigations will complete, they will make the results available for you as early as possible. If the patient is still not satisfied with all explanation and complaint procedure and decide to sue the hospital, guide them that it is a very expensive procedure. You need a lawyer for that. One of the problem is that once the things take the legal action, it will stop all investigations and complaints in the hospital. It might be best to hear the results before you decide the legal action and give them the written information leaflet. Okay, this is the second task. Dr. Saima. Okay, Dr. Saima. Waiting, she's waiting. Okay, and Dr. Rashida. Dr. Rashida? Please unmute yourself, Dr. Rashida, if you want to become a candidate for the task. Dr. Nandita. Dr. Nandita, please unmute your mic. Nandita, Dr. Rashida, Dr. Saima. No one? Anyone want to be a candidate for the task? Anyone of you?
Just type in the
chat box. Yes, Niranjan. Vinesh Niranjan, I want to present. Yeah. Okay, Mr. Vinesh Niranjan, am I audible to you? Please unmute your mic if you want to become a candidate for the task. Vinesh, you are unmuted, Mr. Vinesh. You can start now.
Hello.
Hello.
Am I audible?
But your voice is not clear.
Am I audible now?
Yeah. Now you are audible. If may I know your name, please?
Yeah, I'm Shraddha.
Shraddha. Okay, Shraddha, you want to become the candidate for the task?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. You have 2 minutes. Okay, your time starts now. Okay.
May I check in your age?
I'm 30 years old.
Yeah, Sara, I've received a letter from your GP stating that you are pregnant 34 weeks and he has some concern from your pregnancy. Is that true?
Yes, doctor, yes it is.
Yeah, Sara, will it be all right that I ask you questions to know more about your condition? Then maybe examine you, run few tests if required, and then I'll explain the options available for you.
Okay, fine, doctor.
Yeah, Sarah, yeah, can you tell me more about your pregnancy?
Yeah, as this is my third pregnancy and I'm 34 weeks pregnant. Everything is fine right now, but I have some pain in my tummy and it is bothering me, for which I present for almost 3 times to my GP, and he just give me some regular painkiller. I'm so worried about that. I just want to be pain-free as early as possible.
Yeah, can you tell me more about your pain?
Yeah, it just comes and goes, not every time, and mostly at night, and it's a sort of some sharp pain I have.
What aggravates your pain?
There's no thing, nothing. It can be at any time, mostly at night.
Anything which relieves your pain?
Yeah, there's a few painkillers which GP advised me.
Does it radiate to anywhere?
No, nowhere. On the lower part of my tummy.
Okay. Otherwise, how has been your scan and blood reports, everything?
Yeah, till now? Fine. Yeah, up till now, everything is just fine.
Yeah. Is it a planned pregnancy?
Yes, it is. No, sorry. It's not a planned pregnancy. It's an unplanned pregnancy.
Are you happy to carry it?
Yeah. I welcome the pregnancy. When I found that I'm pregnant, so I welcome the pregnancy.
Okay. Can you tell me about your previous pregnancies?
Yeah, it was just fundamental pregnancies. I ended up into the cesarean section because my first baby was in the bottom first position. And there's no problem in that pregnancy.
And second was also cesarean?
Yes, yeah. I have 2 baby boys.
Okay. How are they doing?
Yeah, they're fine.
Okay. Has your periods been regular?
Yeah, they are.
Any condition for which you follow your GP regularly?
No.
Apart from 2 cesarean, any other surgery in your tummy or down below?
No.
Any allergies you have?
No, not at all.
Are you update with your smears?
Yes, I am.
Hello?
Yes, I am.
Yeah. With whom do you live, Sarah?
My husband.
Is he supportive?
Yeah. He is supportive.
What do you do for your living?
I'm a housewife.
Okay. Do you smoke, Sarah?
No.
Take alcohol?
No.
Any recreational drugs?
No.
Do you know your BMI? Highest weight ratio?
I think it's normal.
Is there anything else you want to add, Sarah?
No, doctor. Just I want to be pain-free as early as possible. Because it
definitely, definitely. Yeah, I'll come to it and I'll try to be of maximum help for you, okay? Yeah, Sarah, now I'd like to examine you in the presence of a chaperone with your consent. I'll ask my midwife to record your blood pressure, and I would like to examine your tummy to see the size of the baby and record the baby's heart rate. How does it sound?
Okay. Yeah.
No. Okay. Sarah, as I have examined you and the GP noted certain bruises in your tummy, and till now all the reports are normal. So can you tell me what could be the cause of pain?
Nothing, doctor. I just fell from the stairs. So that's why I get these bruises a few days ago.
Sarah, Okay. Sara, whatever we are going to discuss is going to be confidential. And I'm not going to write to you, not even to your GP, without your permission, until there is a serious threat to you or your baby. All right?
Okay.
Sara, these bruises are not of the same age. Can you tell me more about your bruise?
Doctor, actually my husband hurt me on and off. So that's why he hit me on my tummy and on my thigh. So that's why I get these bruises.
I'm so sorry to hear that, Sara. None of the women deserves to be treated that way. Has he done it this in front of your children also?
Yeah, sometimes.
Does he hit you?
Yeah.
Does he carry a weapon?
No, not at all.
Sara, do you feel safe at home? Hello?
Yes, carry on. Not every time.
Has he ever threatened your life, Sara?
No, not at all. Just hit me on and off.
Okay. Okay, Sara, this is a condition called domestic violence, and I'm really concerned because every week we are losing two women because of domestic violence, and help is available there, and you can take help only if you wish. Okay, and we are all there to help you. So what I will do, Sara, I'll refer you to the hospital specialist for this domestic violence. So we'll help you with that. And also I can refer you to the women's refugee. These are the women's aid. They have they are 24-hour service who can help you with refugee service. They can provide you with financial aid, and they can help you in many ways.
It is not possible for me to go because I'm totally dependent of financially and socially on my husband, and he will not allow me to go there.
Definitely, Sara. So what I can do, I'll give you the phone number in a piece of paper so that your husband cannot identify. And what you can just give them a call, and they will contact you at a suitable time so that when your husband is not there, and they can make the arrangement for you. Okay.
Okay.
And also, you need to make a safety planning for yourself. That is, you should. It is a good idea that you keep a set of clothes, your car ring, and the bank account and passport number in the photocopied, so that whenever need arises, you can move out of the house, and these things will serve you, will help you. Okay.
Okay. It sounds good.
Sara, I have given you lots of information. I'll refer you to the midwife also, and give you the websites where you can check, and refer you to the women's aid also. And whatever I'm going to discuss, this I'll document not in your handheld notes, but in a separate note which can help you, which will act as a legal document also whenever you wish. How does it sound?
Yeah, thank you, doctor.
Is there anything you want to discuss, Sara?
No, I think it's fine.
Okay. Sara, help is there. Please take the help. Thank you, Sara. Okay. Thank you for your time.
Okay. Well done, Chadra. Very good. So you almost cover each and every point of the domestic violence. This is a station of our difficult patients, which might come in the exam, but you forget about the baby. You need to ask about the baby. You need to examine. You need to run certain investigation in the form of ultrasound, because they can be placental abruption. So you need to rule out that. But the rest of the session was excellent. Well done. Okay. So just mute your mic. Okay, thank you. So this is a task of the difficult patient. Mostly it is in the form of an hidden agenda. When you will go inside the cubicle, and when you talk to the role player, then the role player will show you certain clues, like the role player will have an eye-to-eye contact with you, and either it's basically a hint for you that history taking is not required. You need to explore her concerns. Okay, so there can be the station like PMS, chronic pelvic pain, sexual abuse, and child abuse can come in the form of a difficult patient. And sometimes they may come a refugee as well. and the cases of female genital mutilation, usually in the form of a difficult patient. So this is a template which I have made. You can apply it to any difficult patient. In fact, I am going to give you some homework as well. You need to send me the recording of the task and apply these templates. First, introduction, greeting, and identify the identity confirmation. Break ice by asking about the expectation. Do you have any expectation, any concern that you want to discuss with me before we begin today's consultation? Then confirm the aim of the meeting. Yeah, please, everyone, mute your mic. Interrupting our communication. So after the introduction, you can say, good afternoon. My name is Dr. Alina, and I'm one of the senior doctors in the antenatal clinic today. Nice to meet you. Is that okay if I confirm your full name, please? But would you like me to call you? Please call me Alina. Breaking ice by asking, do you have any expectation that you want to discuss with me before we begin today's consultation? I have a letter from your GP, and the GP said that you have some pain in your tummy. Is that correct? Do you need to add anything? And set an agenda of the consultation and show the empathy with your facial expression. I'm so sorry, Sara. It must be very difficult for you. I will try my best to resolve your pain as early as possible. Are you in pain right now? I'm going to give you an effective analgesia to make you pain-free. Then you need to set an agenda. Okay, I'm going to ask you questions from you so that I will be in the better position to discuss. Then I will suggest, then I may need to examine you in the presence of Heffron and may suggest some of the investigations from you. Then we will make a management plan, or I will make certain options available for you depending upon your wishes and expectations. First thing is, when you suspect from the body language of the role player that this is a difficult patient, you need to probe by saying, is everything okay, Sara? Is there anything that you want to discuss with me? I just want to reassure you that what we discuss today will remain strictly confidential. I will not discuss to anyone, even not with GP, without your consent. Please feel free to talk with me. Show your empathy. I'm so sorry, Sara. You are passing through a very hard time. This is a terrible thing that happened with you. Offer help. I cannot see you like this, Sara. Please tell me, Sara, is there anything I can do for you? I just want to help you. Offer support and counselor. And then is a strategy or an agreed management plan. This is the point of the templates. You can apply on any of the difficult patients. Okay, so I tried to write this task as well. After introduction, greeting, and identify the confirmation, break ice. I can see in your notes that this is your third pregnancy and you are 34 weeks pregnant. Am I correct? Do you have any expectations? I have a letter from your GP state that this. Next is an agenda which I have already been explained to you. Even if there is no information gathering, still you all need to take the relevant history because it will be helpful for you to make a management plan. Can you please tell me something more about your pain? Is it all times or just come and go? How's the baby is moving? Is your tummy growing appropriately according to your pregnancy? Have you noticed any bleeding and discharge from your down below? What I need to do today is I just need to examine you in the presence of chaperone and arrange a quick scan for you because I just want to make sure that you and the baby are absolutely fine and there is nothing we need to be worried about. Okay? Then you need to show the sympathy. I'm so sorry, Sara. When she will say that I'm having my husband hurt you, then you need to say that I'm so sorry, Sara. You are living in a terrible situation and no woman deserves to be treated like me. Then you can offer her help. Sara, are you afraid at home? Is there anything I can do for you? Have you talked to anyone in your family, with your friends, with your sister, with your mother? We have a specialist counselor who deals with women in such circumstances. How do you feel about this? You also need to ask that, is he the father of your children? Did he hurt them too? If it is like that, then we need to inform the child protection team. But we will talk to you first before we inform the child protection team. You also offer them help by saying the domestic violence service is a 24-hour available service at all times. They have a specialist whose job is to help women who are in abusive relationships in some part of their life. You can contact them at any time. They will support you in your decision. Either you want to stay with your husband or not and arrange a refugee for you. It is safe. Is it safe for you to take their card? I'm going to give you my number as well. We are going to fix another appointment, particularly when it is suitable for you, when your husband is not at home. Please, please don't forget about the baby. Right now, I'm going to arrange some of the tests and scan for you to make sure that everything is okay. Then I'm going to give you some leaflet or the contact number and help you can seek. Keep it in safe place. You should have a regular visit then, but please do not hesitate to seek help. Remember, hidden agenda is usually something she's loath to disclose. It can be in the form of domestic violence, depression, PMS, chronic pelvic pain, sexual or child abuse. She will skate around the issue until you have gained her confidence. In the exam, the role play will give the information if you ask the right question. If you will not ask the right question, the role play will not give you the clues, will not give you the required information. If the role player is not going to have an eye-to-eye contact with you, just stop there. Just ask from the role player that, is it everything okay? How do you feel right now? Anything that you want to discuss with me, then just reassure her that what we will discuss today is strictly confidential. So that role player will discuss with you everything. Okay, so these are the templates for the difficult patient. If you have a role player who has the problem of, or you suspect that she has some depression, you need to ask in the two questions, that is a Woolley's depression score. In the past few months, have you ever bothered being feeling down and depressed? Or in the past few months, have you often been more worried about the things? And if any of the question is correct, you can ask, is there anything that you need to seek help with it? If you can also say that many women have frightening thoughts about harming themselves and their baby, and they are too scared and ashamed to talk about this to anyone. Is there anything like that ever happened to you? If she says yes, then she is in the severe depression. So you need to explore this by saying that. There can be a task of child abuse. You can say that many children are abused. They can be physical, emotional, psychological, and social. So you can ask from the patient that how was your childhood be like? Did anything bad ever happen to you? Were your parents happy together? Did they separate or divorce? What age were you when this happened? How was your relationship with your parents? Had you have the opportunity to talk about this to everyone? Offer support and counselor and ask, did she need to inform the police? Okay, so domestic violence, which we have already been discussed, you can say that no woman deserves to be treated that way. You are not alone. Every one in four women are abused, either in the form of physical, psychological, social, and emotional way. Offer help, support, and with the help of a counselor. Tell her about the domestic violence service, child protection service, if the children are at risk, arrange refugee and financial support for her. Ask her to inform police and to rescue her if she is at risk. And also, don't forget about the baby. There can be a station of PMS or the chronic pelvic pain. You can ask similar questions of the child abuse, which we have already been discussed, because there is some hidden agenda inside, usually in such type of tasks. Estimate the severity of depression by asking, how do you feel right now? Many women with such difficult experience may have thought that their life is hopeless, not worth living. Have you experienced such thoughts? Have you thought about how you might hurt yourself? So this, from these questions, you can assess the severity of the depression. You may need to ask about the stresses of life, how your and your husband are getting on. Are there any problems at work? Because these are the stresses of life. So you can also say that the woman is not just only woman. They are superwoman. They do everything, cooking, cleaning houses, take care of their children, do everything at home. even they don't know from the lifestyle that they are stressed, although they are stressed. Is there anything like that? So can you please tell me about your lifestyle? So these are the hidden agenda, and through these questions, you all can explore the agenda. So this is your homework. You all need to just send me the recording of these tasks by using these templates in the group, and I will give you all the feedback accordingly. So thank you so very much. Well, this is it. So that's all from my side. You can post your question and queries on my Telegram group. And I will share my group details on the Facebook page as well. From there, you can join it via invitation link. And I would appreciate your sincere feedback.
No answer to
your
question.
Okay. Okay, so now I'm going to share, just see the chat. I take a look on the chat and answer your question. Just to wait a minute. Chat. Boy. I want to. No questions. No, there is no such question. Okay, so there is no such questions. So if you all have any questions in your mind, just post on my Telegram group and I will happy to answer. So I'm going to finish my meeting. And please don't forget to give the feedback. Okay, thank you so much.